picking up in Henderson, South Carolina. Just 40 miles away from it. So I'm about to head over there now. The pickup is at, pickup appointment is at 2. So I'm gonna be there 1 hour before his appointment. So now I'm leaving this Flying J. So one pickup, one drop. Delivering in Winter Haven, Florida. So, it's a decent load, but you know, leaving out of Florida, I will have to deadhead out because the loads are just garbage coming up. But this is the only load that I got that was paid decent, you know, so I take it. I don't mind leaving out of Florida without a load. But I wish the rates were much better leaving out here. So I'm just starting my week. I did a 34-hour reset over the weekend. gotta see this view right here. This is Highway 187 in South Carolina. And gotta say, it's a beautiful state. Is at, but it doesn't look complicated the way it's a big facility. It doesn't look complicated at all.
Process where they just take your truck number
they ask to see your ID, and then you proceed to check in at the shipping office. But they do everything there at the car shop, which makes sense. You know, I wish a lot of other warehouses followed suit. So 1 hour 30 minutes it took to load. So let's see what's back there. It's toilet paper, and they left our seal back here. Yeah, toilet paper, guys. So I put a strap on the top stack just to make sure it doesn't tip over or collapse. So it's a green seal today. Drop it in. Boom. We're good. So now it's time to proceed to the guard shack for my paperwork. They're gonna check me out. dinner time, you know. And I'm about to match up some dumpling with some mackerel. That's why that onion is right there waiting. So it's time to put the dumpling in. So I'm gonna show you guys that. So I just pull over at the service area here. There's no facility, but I like the shade, so that's why I come here. I'm right under the shade. So I'm gonna max up some dumpling with mackerel. Stick and stay to see this one, guys. Check on it now. Oh yeah, I put some mixed vegetables in. Alright guys, so the dumpling is out, the mixed vegetable is out. So now I'm warming up the oil to put the onions in. And this is what I'm gonna do today. So mackerel. Of course I eat mackerel. You know what I mean? This is a Jamaican thing. Can't live with my mackerel yet. So once the oil hot, guys, I'm gonna put the onions in and then I'm gonna show you guys. So just stick and stay for that. But just check out the mixed vegetable and the dumpling. Wouldn't you eat it just like that? Let me know in the comment section. But no, for me, I need the mackerel in it. So this is a quick and easy cook. You don't have to use this much onion, but I sorry. Yeah, I cut the onion. So once I cut the onion, there's no point of putting down the other half. So I just use all of it because it will go bad. So that's me gonna just use all of it with this big tin of mackerel. And this is just a one eat for me. Let me know, guys, what you think about this recipe. Easy cook. Easy, easy. Alright, peeps, so the oil should be hot and ready now. Let's see what's going on first. Alright, I think I'll fill up. Prop up. Alright, let's put the onion.
got pepper. Check on the onion now. Just use the final step to put the mackerel in. Easy to open. No need for a knife.
Mash up these chunks. Make them more desirable. I'm gonna add a little bit of water. What better way to do it than to dip a little in the can. Stir it around. Now the final two things I'm gonna add is some hot sauce. Smells so good, people. Alright, now let it stay for like 5 minutes and then take it off. It's pretty much done. Taste test, people. Now it's time for a taste test. Alright, time for a taste test. Check it out. General people eat nice, but and it's not because I'm hungry right now, it's really good. The mackerel has a little hint of spice. Dumpling is soft. serve it up. It's really good. This is the mixed vegetable and the mackerel together. Guys, you gotta try this recipe. Easy, easy, easy recipe. People are like, seven dumplings, man, match up enough. Seven dumplings. It's delicious, people. Check it out. Dumpling, mackerel, mixed vegetable. One time. This is what you call dinner. No Burger King, no pizza. Some real food. Feel good already, huh? This is it. Mackerel and rice? No. Mackerel and dumpling this time. Mackerel and dumpling with mixed vegetable. You gotta try it. You just gotta try it. Tastes better than these truck stop pizzas, frozen sandwich, chicken wings. You know what I mean? This is it, yo. Fresh food, nothing stale. Cook outside the truck. Outdoor cooking style, you know? This is just one of my recipes so far. Got plenty more to come. Trying to make several dumplings look like three. Down to the final dumpling now. This plastic spoon, I get to work, you know, peeps. My mouth is on fire right now. I'm gonna make this right. The traffic light. Just under 8 minutes from the Walmart. But the sunrise is not with us, guys. But it's not affecting you all. It's to my left. It's just starting to peek out from behind the clouds. We're getting closer to Walmart. There's a Walmart truck. Truck, so the left lane is for one more trucks only, and the right lane is for OTR drivers. So I'm just gonna line up behind this truck, stretch a little bit, loosen up my bone tissues, everything. that is tightened up. The Walmarts are pulling in. They have like their express lane. Left lane is the express lane. So I'm gonna take you guys down from here and go in this door right here. Door 40. Between the post and the trailer. Just gonna open these doors. To walk my papers in to receiving office and drop my trailer and pull forward. Minutes, guys. I got a call. I'm unloaded, so I'm walking back to the CRO office to collect my bills. Passing these reefer trailers. So after collecting this bill, guys, I'm just gonna hook back up to my trailer and bounce from here. But this is where I'm gonna close out the video, guys. Make sure to subscribe to the channel if you're new. If you're just stopping by, like, share, tell a friend to tell a friend. Tune in to Faro Chuckin'.